Hello, my charmed ones, and welcome back to my channel for another video. So today we're going to be talking about something that I think is very important for each of us to understand, and that is the scientific reason why habits are hard to change. Now, I have done videos on changing habits in the past, so I think this is something where if you wanted some more in-depth on like how to do it, I'll leave some links down below. You can check out some previous videos, but there is information that I've come across, you know, through my research that really explains why it's hard to change a habit. I think we all understand that it's hard to change our habits, to either like get rid of a bad habit or add a new habit in. But I think it's really important to understand the actual neurology of what's going on in your brain when you're forming a new habit, how to build up habits to be more long lasting, and to really understand the struggles that you are likely going to face. And I say likely, it's like definitely you're going to face if you're trying to change habits. Because I do think it's so important for us to feel empowered when it comes to this area of our lives. There's a quote that I've used before by John C. Maxwell that says, "You'll never change your life until you change something you do daily. The secret of your success is found in your daily routine." And I really do believe that. And I think that if you're someone who is trying to change some little things in your life to try to have different results, right? You want to change something in your life, you want to change the outcomes, and you know that those outcomes are based on your actions, then it's really important to understand the things that are going to hold you back and to have realistic expectations for kind of like the journey, because changing your habits is in many ways an uphill journey. So that is why I'm sharing this with you today. I want to make sure you guys have reasonable expectations, that you understand the science behind how it works, so you can be better prepared. Because when I learned this information, I was like, oh, that makes a lot of other things I've learned and knew about habits clearer to me. So I'm going to explain all this to you as we go along in this video. First of all, I want to say that this idea of this neurology that I'm talking about with you, sharing with you, comes from a book by Dr. Joe Dispenza, who he happens to be one of my favorite like personal development, metaphysics sorts of researchers, writers, authors, influencers, I guess. And he's written many books. I believe that this information is found in his book called Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself, but I will leave some links down below to other books of his that I've read, because I've read a bunch of them. So it's possible that this actually was found in another book instead, but I think it was from Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself. So first, let me start off by explaining what happens in your brain, in your neurology, when you do new things. Your brain is a wonderful little record keeper for you. Anytime you do something, it records it in your brain by creating new neural pathways. And if you didn't know this, neural pathway is basically just the material of neurological pieces of nerves and clusters kind of built into that like white matter of your brain. So if you think about it, your brain, your entire personality, everything that you've experienced in your life is in some way or another recorded in like this neural net. And I say net because it probably very likely looks like a webbing, right? Like netting. It's all branching and different pathways that connect to each other and different like synapses, all these sorts of scientific words we don't really have to go into. I don't even fully understand all of it. So your brain maps out your entire life in your brain, in your neural pathway. And whenever you do something new, your brain is triggered to create new neural material. It'll start like a new neural pathway, right? It'll connect some new area of your brain together based on what you're doing. And it's a very fascinating thing that ends up happening when you do new things, because when new neural pathway is created in your brain, your brain actually has to dig into the RNA. I believe it's the RNA, not your DNA. And what it does is it creates new gene expressions. So this means that you end up becoming a little bit on this micro level, like a new person, a new version of yourself every time you do something new. So this is one of those reasons why you should be trying new things and not being afraid of new things, because it actually makes you like a better, stronger version of yourself every time your brain gets an opportunity to change your neural pathway and like add to it, right? It makes you like a better person. You literally become more enriched. So you do something once, your brain will record it by creating this new neural pathway. However, unless you do that thing again, unless that event happens again in the next 15 days, the neural pathway will go away. It will decay, it'll disappear. Because your brain tries to be as pragmatic as possible with storage, right? It's like, okay, something has happened that's new, we need to record it, but if it doesn't happen again, okay, it must have been a fluke, we'll get rid of the information and we'll move on. But if it does happen again, your brain's like, okay, this is a reoccurring, this is a reoccurring anomaly, and we need to be prepared in the future. So we want to keep that pathway permanent. So they make, your brain makes the pathway permanent once you've done something more than once within a 15-day period of time. And I actually believe that this 15-day period of time is the scientific reason behind why some people might talk about, you know, it takes 21 days to form a habit. 21 days is not 15 days, but it's pretty close. And I think this is where it comes from, because it actually takes, I mean, it takes one time for your brain to actually create a pathway. But if you're not reoccurring that habit again, it goes away. So you do need to make sure that you are continuously doing things, you're doing things more than once in order for it to become a permanent part of your brain. So I think that's very interesting. Now, okay, so let's say you do something two times or more within a 15-day period of time, and now your neural net is actually, you know, that part of your neurology is actually solidified. It's going to keep the neural pathway there. The next challenge you have is that just because you added new neural information does not mean that any past neural information has been changed. I think it's helpful to think of these neural pathways in your brain as like the root systems of a tree or of a plant. And if you're familiar with botany and the root systems and things like that, you may know that when a certain root, right, of a plant is getting a consistent flow of nutrients and water and basically the things it needs to survive from that individual root, that root ends up getting stronger and stronger and stronger. It actually becomes thicker and gets bigger, and it'll grow deeper as necessary. And that's similar to the way your neural pathway works. When you've been doing something over and over and over and over and over for days, weeks, months, years, that pathway you can expect to be the bigger branch of your neural pathway. So let's say you have a bad habit that at this point is, we're going to say something big. I'm just going to use some, you know, visuals here for you, my arm here. You've got a nice solid branch of your neural pathway that's saying, okay, this is the thing that we do. This is the habit that we do. Even if you want to change, you want to change that. So one day you're like, okay, instead of doing this habit, you think to yourself logically, like, okay, I'm in control of my brain. I'm going to do this thing instead. And then you do it again or a few times in the 15 days and the neural pathway is permanent. But that neural pathway is like, in comparison, tiny, right? It's like the size of my finger versus the size of my forearm, right? So what happens is the next time you go to do your new habit, right? Your brain is actually going to say, well, look, we know this is here, but you actually want to do this because this is the stronger pathway. This has deeper roots in your brain. This is the way we want to go. And even if you're stopping and telling your brain, no, no, brain, I really want to do this. I should do this, right? What it's going to start doing, because your brain is not just in control of your neural pathway and your neural network, it's in control of basically every system of your body, your parasympathetic, your sympathetic nervous system. It controls really your nerves everywhere. It's going to start telling you things, or sending you signals rather, that are going to make you not want to do the new habit, because the new habit is so tiny. It's like, well, we have this better option, this bigger, stronger, better pathway. Like, why take this rickety back road when you can take the nice, well-paved highway to get to where you're going? That's how your brain is thinking. So what it's going to do is tell you, wait, you should really be doing this instead. And it's going to give you a little bit of anxiety around the new thing. And that's to be expected. You know, if you've ever tried to change a habit, right? Do a new habit, you know, establish something new in your life. You may find that like your brain will try to default to doing the other thing, right? Whatever you've been doing that might be a bad habit, or just not, it doesn't have to be bad, just something else. Your brain's like, no, we normally do this. And so this is what we want to do. And when you try to get yourself to logically choose the option that you're interested in changing into, you may start feeling anxious, right? Your brain might start popping up and going a million miles an hour, telling you all the reasons why you shouldn't do this. I want you to understand right now that that's not you making that choice. That's not you having your brain run away with different thoughts. That's your brain the autopilot of your brain trying to get you to choose the option that is more well-established. So when you struggle to execute on your new habit, let's say you're waking up in the morning and you want to go to the gym, right? You're like, okay, we're going to wake up and the first thing I'm going to do in the morning is go to the gym. You're going to wake up in the morning, and because it's something new that you haven't done, if this is, you know, a situation that resonates with you, your brain's going to say, no, we should continue to sleep. We shouldn't get up right now. And, or we should, you know what we should do? We should do that thing we usually do in the morning. We shouldn't go to the gym. And what's going to happen is your brain's talking you, the conscious area of your brain that is your thoughts, that's your active brain. Your brain is trying to change your active mind. It's almost like there's more than one person up there. There's just one person for most of us, but you know, your brain will start to try to influence you in different ways. And the reason it's doing this is because it thinks in the past, it thinks that what kept you alive up until this point is what's going to keep you alive in the future, even though we know that that's not necessarily true. There is no guide in your body that your brain has that says this is the way to keep Alexis alive. This is the way to keep you alive. Instead, it only learns how to keep you alive based on past experiences that you survived. So the fact that you never went to the gym in the morning before this has kept you alive until here. Doesn't matter what the state of your health is and how maybe going to the gym would improve that and lengthen your life. Your brain doesn't know that. Your brain's living in the past and saying, no, we shouldn't do this because we don't normally do this and I want to keep you alive. So this is something that I think is, to me, was kind of like a really big aha moment, because it explains why changing habits is hard. It explains why the first few weeks of doing a new habit can be sometimes the toughest, and why even if you go through those weeks and you get to that point where you've solidified the neural pathway, your brain will still want to default to the pathway that is the strongest, right? So I think this is good information to have because it will help you better prepare and better manage your own emotions and your own choices when it comes time to make that better choice to take that smaller neural pathway that might be the neural pathway that you want to change into, really to help you understand that you are going to get resistance from your brain and what the resistance looks like. Like I said, the resistance would look like lots of different thoughts popping into your head trying to distract you. Right? The resistance might look like anxiety. It might feel like anxiety where your brain is actually saying, no, do not go to the gym this morning. You may die if you do that. Like your brain will start giving you anxiety like that. And it's a little bit, it seems a little crazy when we think about it, but it's the way our brain works. And so I think that if you can understand that, you can kind of make a plan and really expect, okay, I'm going to go to the gym tomorrow morning. And when this happens, you know I'm going to panic, but I just have to force myself to do it, right? I just have to get myself to not even think about it, to just try to automatically like put the gym clothes on, grab the gym bag and head out before my brain causes me too much anxiety. Or what might end up happening for you, something that I think is a strategy that sometimes works very well, is when you tell yourself, okay, we're not focused on going to the gym, but what I'm going to do right now instead is I'm just going to put the gym shoes on. I'm just going to put the gym clothes on. And now I'm just going to go downstairs and I'm just going to drive to the gym. We don't have to necessarily go in, but I'm just going to drive to the gym. Like, don't panic, brain. You know what I mean? You take the small steps. You kind of give yourself like these smaller little micro habits that would build up to the new habit of going to the gym, let's say. And hopefully your brain, will acclimate the more and more you get closer to the gym, to the point of you're like, well, you're just outside the gym now, you might as well go in. You know what I mean? And work out. So I hope that helps. I hope that understanding the neurology of the way habits are formed and why it's hard helps you to think of a strategy that helps you prepare for the panic and also helps to kind of give you a sense of grace with yourself. That if you're trying to do and establish a new habit and you find that like, oh, it's just not working for me. Like I can't do it. And thinking, you know, you're probably sitting there judging yourself, right? I know I've done this before where I'm just like, why can you not get your act together, Alexis? But it's not Alexis. It's Alexis's brain that's doing it. And it's doing it for the best of reasons. But this is where we have to kind of like take a step back and be like, I have to be the adult here and choose the different habit, so I can choose the new outcomes and the new results in my life. sense? I hope it does. I hope that this little conversation we had today has been helpful for you. I would love to hear about if this was an aha moment for you. And maybe if you'd like to share maybe some strategies that you might want to execute on in order to kind of trick your brain into trying the new thing. Because it really is a matter of keeping your wits about you. That's the best way I can say it. You got to keep your wits about you when you're dealing with habit change, because your brain will try to trick you. And so often we actually associate ourselves with our brain and think that that pull that we're feeling not to do the right thing and to, you know, make the easy choice instead of the new harder choice that's going to develop us into the new person and the new life we want, you know, we feel like bad, like there's something wrong with us. There's nothing wrong with you. Your brain is working exactly how it's supposed to. So I want to hear about your experiences, how you plan to use this information down below in the comments. Let's get some really good examples going on. And if you're someone who has maybe perhaps tried to execute and maybe successfully executed on some habit change, let us know some tips that worked for you so we can all learn and grow and become better and get better results in our lives, okay? Oh, and one more thing, something important I wanted to tell you guys. For those of you who are really interested in my content, like these sorts of topics that we talk about, I wanted to let you guys know that I am seriously getting back into blogging again. I have been working on some new content. I am working myself back up to my 3 posts a week schedule over on my blog. So if you are interested in following along, I highly recommend that you also check me out at www.strangecharmed.com. I will leave a link down below, but get my blog link, save it, favorite it, put it in an RSS feed, however you like to read blogs. There's even an option actually on my website where you can put your email in and you can just get like my email blasts of just my blog posts. That's it. So if that's something you're interested in, if you like this content, definitely check me out on my blog because I've got a lot of cool new things coming. I really have been working on my editorial calendar for you guys, and I'm really motivated to create some wonderful pieces of content for you guys in 2020 outside of YouTube. So definitely can't wait to see you over there on my blog. Thank you guys so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you want more of the behind the scenes of my productivity life and business, follow me on Instagram at Miss Trenchcoat. And if you're not yet subscribed to this channel, what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button for more awesome videos by me. And until next time, bye-bye.